make sure that you're filling the front lines first. From the other section here at the front, there's plenty of room. I don't even think the first line is complete here to my left, to your right. So I can have some of the runners who already started the rows 3, 4, and 5, please stand up, look at your shoes, and take them down to the side here, and please complete those rows before you can get a new rule. Otherwise, you're going to have a little bit of a traffic jam, especially for a lot of people coming through those doors. I'd also like to remind you that, of course, an event like this doesn't happen without your vendors' donations. We do have volunteers who find that walking up and down through the aisles with donation boxes, so please make sure that you donate generously to that. You'll also find large cardboard donation boxes throughout the facility. You'll see them along the aisles, prayer aisles, as well.
Allahu Akbar, as many heads being shaved in this great day in obedience المسلمون. Fear Allah, all you who believe, as he should be feared, and do not die except on a state of Islam. This is an important day, the day of Eid, the greatest feast of Muslims, where Muslims all over the world gather in obedience and submission to our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, following the footsteps of our beloved Prophet Ibrahim and Muhammad alayhi wa salatu wa salam, showing the whole world how Muslims are submissive to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how obedient to the commandments of our Lord. The significance of this Eid comes as its importance to sacrifice, to give, and to share. This is how this Eid came about. And if you want to really have real joy and celebration of this Eid, we have to follow what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has left for us. When he says, "Taraktu fikum amran," I have left you with two things. If you hold tight to them, you will not go astray. It is the book of Allah and the sunnah, the path and the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this day, and when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had his final pilgrimage, Hajjat al-Wada, there was a universal proclamation of the human rights that signifies the importance of this event. The uniqueness of our religion. We know there are other religions, there are other cultures exist. But the uniqueness of our religion, that it has a mission that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty, has sent the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to complete all religions. اليوم أتممت لكم دينكم. اليوم أتممت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي. Today I have completed your religion and perfected your religion and completed my blessing upon you and have chosen for you Islam as your religion. This is the uniqueness. It came as a perfection to all religions. By the same token, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with the mission, إِنَّمَا بُعِدْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ, that I have been sent to perfect the best of manners. So the quality of Islam, the quality of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the quality of your religion that you should be proud of, it came to complete and to perfect religions and best of manners. In his proclamation in Hajjat al-Wada', our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke of 4 points which are relevant today and will be relevant at all times. The first of this is the sanctity of life, the sanctity of private ownership, and the sanctity of honor. This is a very important pillar that if humanity today respect and observe and follow the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we will not see all of what we are seeing today in the bloodshed that existed throughout history and nowadays. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam proclaiming, Ya ayyuha al-nas, to all humanity, all people, Inna dima'akum wa amwalakum alaykum haramun ila an tabtu rabbakum, that your blood and your property are haram. You are not allowed to take it from one another until you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sanctity of the blood, the sanctity of your property, the sanctity of your honor, is as important as the sanctity of this day. كحرمة يومكم هذا في شهركم هذا في بلدكم هذا. The sanctity of this day and this month and in this place which the Bayt al-Haram in Mecca. This is how important the sanctity of life and how important the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam drawing the attention to all humans, all humanity. He didn't speak to Muslims, say, Ya ayyuha al-Nas, all humans. And if we look throughout history, we see Muslims have been suffering because of this bloodshed in all places. In Palestine, and in Afghanistan, and in Iraq, and in Bosnia, and in Chechnya, and in Burma, and most recently, our hearts are feeling the pain of our Muslims in Syria, and how much they are suffering of the bloodshed, of the nonsense killing of innocent men and women. There's no sanctity to life, to children, to elderly. This is happening in masses of thousands and 10,000 of innocent humans. Their blood has been shed in Syria and in Burma as late as this morning. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give Muslims strength and show them the straight path to stand up against this and to proclaim the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to all humanity. That our lives are sacred, our properties are sacred, and our honor is sacred as well. The second proclamation of a human right is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than 1400 years spoke about, is to stand up against discrimination. All aspects of discrimination, whether it's religious or social, or economical, or tribal, you name it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made it clear. And in the hadith, he says, these are the actions of jahiliyyah, the actions of the time of ignorance that preceded the time of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ala wa inna kulla shay'in min amri jahiliyyah tahta khadamayya mawdu'. And everything, all matters from jahiliyyah, from the time of ignorance, are under my feet. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in a humiliation of these practices, the bloodshed that existed, it has to go away. Dima'ul jahiliyyah mawdu'a, and he started. Wa inna awwal damin ala. من دمائنا ذنب ربيع بن الحارث. The first blood that he will forgive and he will put under his feet is the blood of Ibn Rabi' ibn al-Harith, one of the people of Quraysh. Not only that, but also economic equity. A lot of what we see today is happening because of the greed. And the essence of the greed that exists today is usually the riba. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this hadith, وَأَوَّلْ رِبَا أَضَعْ إِلَّا الْعَبَّاسِ فَإِنَّهُ مُضُوعٌ كُلُّهُ. He forgave the riba of Abbas. So no more bloodshed, no more usury. So people can live in peace. There is no wealthy people will suck the blood of the innocent, the blood of hard-working men and women like you. Because they have to pay usury and they have to pay so-called nice interest nowadays. These are very important pillars which will bring social justice, which will bring peace to society and prevent a lot of bloodshed that may have existed throughout history because of the greed. The third proclamation of human rights that the Prophet spoke about in Hajjat al-Wada is to take care of women, and he specifically pointed out women because of their important role. And hunna awanun lakum, women are your partners and your helpers. Astawsu bin nisa'i khayra. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam proclaims, to take care of women, whether they are your mothers, because we know that paradise flows under the feet of mothers, whether they are your wives. وأنتم لباس لهم. They are your apparel and you are their apparel and you are a parent to them. Whether they are your daughters, because daughters will shield you from the hellfire, will protect you from the hellfire if you take a proper care of raising your children and your daughters specifically. And whether they are your sisters, because the mu'minun wal mu'minat ba'dhum awliya wa ba'd, the believers, men and women, they are allied to one another. They are helpers of one another. They join good and forbid evil. And the last proclamation of human rights, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke about in Hajj al-Wada', which is very relevant and very important as the other three, is the unity of Ummah. And we have to be careful about this. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Al-Shaytan gave up, Satan gave up to be worshipped by those who prefer prayers. He has no hope for you to worship him." That is the Shaytan. But he has big hopes and a lot of achievements of causing trouble, at-tahrish bainahum, in causing conflict and enmity among believers. This is where Shaytan succeeded. This is where Satan succeeded, is to create enmity and deviation among Muslims. Whether we're talking about Muslims at the level of the statehood, Muslim states, they are divided, they are in conflict, they might be in fight, or Muslim society, or Muslim organization and groups, as close as here in Canada. And that's why we should have a mission, and we should have a goal to unite as one Ummah. Because if you want to defeat Satan, this is how we can defeat it. Satan has no hope for us to pray for him or to worship him. So let's work together. We have very clear prescription from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you want to fulfill the mission why Muslims are here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And I have created men and jinn, humans and jinns, for only one purpose. For only one purpose, to worship me. This is your mission, all Muslims, if you don't know it yet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this very single, clear mission. If you want to be saved at the personal level, if you want humanity to be saved, if you want your community to be saved, follow this, go towards this mission. Have goals to fulfill the proper worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very clear and very simple. Our religion is very simple, very perfect. We have what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, two things, the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, there has come to you from Allah, from Almighty, a light and a clear book. يَهْدِي بِهِ اللَّهُ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رِضْوَانَهُ سُبُلَ السَّلَامِ وَيُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَيَهْدِيهِمْ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. What are the quality of this light and this book? As the Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, by which Allah guides those who pursue His pleasure to the ways of peace and brings them out of darkness into the light by His permission and guides them to a straight path. You have the light, you have the clear book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you, that can guide you to straight path, that can take you from darkness to light. What are you waiting for? My dear brothers and sisters, your mission is clear. Your guidance is perfected for you and protected for you to follow. It's only up to you if you want to do it or not. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم أن الله وأنتم مؤمنون بالإجابة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. My dear brothers and sisters, one last point before we wrap up this ceremony. Again, this is a very important occasion. Shows the sacrifice, shows the commitment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there are so many things in Islam we can do. But please have your mission clear that you're here created to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one very important and very simple thing we can do, Muslims here that is gathered under this roof, is to follow the mission of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he said, "Inna la'ummatu li'utammi marakaim al-akhlaq," that I has been sent to fulfill the best of manners. And one of the manners that Islam stresses, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stresses, is cleanliness. We are the ummah of tahara. Well, al-tahur shatr al-iman, that cleanliness is half of iman. So there is no excuse for us Muslims. It's part of our iman to be clean, to be orderly, to be neat. And we are in this public place, everybody is looking at us. And as every camera is shooting at us, we have to show people who the Muslims are, in their conduct, in their cleanliness, in their orderly, in their meekness, in their passion. When we bring our children to line up for the ride, we have to be patient. We have to have compassion. We have to care about the youngster. And we have to be courteous to each other. If you don't practice Islam at this level, my dear brothers and sisters, we are missing a lot. This is very important and very simple ethics. Islam is a comprehensive set of rules of rituals and of ethics. And they're very easy to follow and do. And there will be a great reward. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Imatatul adha and tariq," is part of the science of iman, musha'ab al-iman, that you remove a dirt from the street. This is how our religion is so practical. It touches each and everyone's life. If you see any dirt in front of you while we're gathered here in masses, pick it up. Show how Muslims are clean. Show how Muslims are care about their iman and their image. And how we are a good role model for humanity. If the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not the right role model for his companions, nobody would have followed him. The first thing, you have to be the right role model. So people would believe that you are really truthful to your message. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us truthful to our message. Make us truthful to our iman. Allahumma aghfir al-muslimin wal-muslimat ya Allah. Wal-mu'minin wal-mu'minat. Al-ahya'i minhum wal-amwat. لك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم انا نسالك ان تلطف بحال اخواننا المستضعفين. اللهم الطف بحال اخواننا في سوريا وفي بورما وفي فلسطين وفي كل بقعه من بقاع الارض يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارهم الحق حقا وارزقهم اتباعه، وارهم الباطل باطلا وارزقهم اجتنابه. اللهم يسر لهم من امرهم رشدا، واحقن دماءهم، واهلك عدوهم وعدوك يا قوي يا جبار يا متين. نسألك يا قوي يا عزيز أن نجعلك في نحور الظالمين، ونعوذ بك من شرورهم. احفظ يا ربي إخواننا وأخواتنا وأمهاتنا وأطفالنا من بين أيديهم ومن خلفهم وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم، ونعوذ بعظمة وجهك أن يغتالوا من تحتهم. Oh Allah, forgive all our sins. Oh Allah, strengthen us in iman. Oh Allah, save the blood of those who are killed innocently. Oh Allah, protect them. Oh Allah, destroy those who are trying to kill innocents. And make them, make the innocent victorious. And make Islam victorious. And make us a peace-loving community that will spread peace and will spread belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and support the weak, and support our ummah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. The next coming 3 days or after this day are the days of Tashriq. You are not allowed to fast. You can have your qurbani until the 13th of the Hijjah, after 3 days. تقبل الله منكم وعيدكم مبارك إن شاء الله. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
We cannot have this event without your donations. It is the day of Eid. Please reach into your pockets, donate generously. Inshallah, so that we can continue to have this event. The next Eid Salah will be 25 minutes at 10 minutes after 11. So I'm going to go over that. And the Juma prayer will be at 1:05. That will be the time of the event.
And he says, three. And I'm going to need a strong volunteer to come up here to prove that these are real. You look very strong. Can you come up here? Thank you. Take one of those. And then I need another volunteer. Almost as strong as you. Could be. He is you. I love your colors. Come up here. Take one of those. And one more person. Find a striping shirt at the back. Come on up. Excellent. You take that. Now the three of you are going to prove to all of them that those are real. So pull on them. You can pull in a bunch of different spots. You can pull in some different spots. Yours is pretty small, so that's good. Okay. Now, let me ask you this. Does that feel like a real piece of rope? Good and strong? Does that feel like a piece of rope? It's not breaking? Good and strong? Very good. I will take this. I will take this. I will take this. And I will ask all of you to give them a great big hand. Take a bow, you guys. Take a little bow. Go and sit down. Go and sit down. Excellent. Now, we have three ropes. Can you turn that back up? Was it a little too loud? All right, there we go. Now, how many ropes are you seeing? And are they the same size? Nobody would say these are the same size, right? All right. Now, let's just check. One is short. One is medium, one is long. Is this one the short, medium, or the long? Put it out of the way. Is this one the medium one or the long one? And that leaves us with this one right here, which is? Very good. One short, one medium, one long. We have three ends there. We have three ends there. I didn't add anything, didn't take anything away, so we're just going to have a short piece of rope there, medium piece of rope there, and a long piece of rope right there. Right? Is that right? What? I think there's something wrong with your eyes because it was a short and a medium and long. Okay, we'll have to do one more test. Let me get rid of one. I'll put one here. And now, how many do you see here? Two. Excellent. So we're going to work with these two, okay? And then, if you wanted to, we could... Let's start with one. That's easy. Okay. We'll start with one rope. You see the ends there? There's two ends there. That means the middle's over here. Two ends there. The middle's over here. Two ends there. The middle is... Okay. Watch this. If I take one, how many ends do you see now? One. So if there's one end there, there's got to be a one end somewhere else. It's got to be over here. Now if I take this one and I do that, how many ends do you see there? Zero. That means that's the middle. So if that's the middle of the rope, then the ends must be both here. That's one, that's the middle, the other end is...
نستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا وسيئات اعمالنا. من يهد الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. اوصيكم عباد الله واياي بتقوى الله واحبكم على طاعته وانهاكم عن مخالفته واستفتحكم الذي هو خير واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وان محمدا عبده ورسوله. اما بعد, in this day, the day of Eid al-Adha, as the name implies, this is the day of sacrifice, the day of giving something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is very appropriate on this day that carries the name of sacrifice to remember the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salam and his family when he took them from Palestine to Mecca. He took his young wife and his infant son from Palestine, from a place that has running water, a place that has vegetation, to a valley that has nothing. As Ibrahim alayhi salam described Mecca then, when he made his prayers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, بوادي غير ذي زرع, in a valley that has no vegetation, barren valley. But he made the sacrifice, and his wife made the sacrifice also. For his wife asked him, is this the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you leave us in this place? And he said yes. And his wife said to him, فَإِنَّهُ لَنْ يُضَيَّنَا, then we will not be lost. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look after us. You left us here in this place and Allah will take it. You leave us here and He will take over. We are not left alone, for He is with us. And this iman, this faith of Hajar alayhi salam, is a great faith that we need to bring in our hearts, to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to ask Him for His support and to realize that He is with us all the time. As Allah, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his young cousin Abdullah ibn Abbas, كُن مع الله في الشدة, كُن مع الله في الرخاء, يَكُن معك في الشدة. Be with Allah when things are easy, and He will be with you when things are difficult. تعرف على الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. So this is something to keep in mind, the sacrifice that the young wife of Ibrahim عليه السلام made is a great sacrifice. But it displays also their faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the same manifests itself many years later with Ismail alayhi salam, when Ibrahim came to him and he told him that I see in my dreams that I am slaughtering you. And the dreams of the prophets salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi are true. And the young man said to his father, افعل ما تؤمر ستجدني ان شاء الله من الصالحين. A young man accepted from his father that he would be slaughtered. This is a great sacrifice. Again, the reason behind accepting it is the submission, Islam, the submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we need to bring this into our hearts, the hearts of those around us, to have unshaken belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to submit to the will of Allah. When we have done our homework, when we have done what we need to do, the rest is left with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with this iman, we will be able to do miracles. We will be able to do a lot of things. If we do not have this faith in our hearts and the reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our deeds, then we will be lost. The Prophet told us that if you rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in true reliance, He will take care of you. But if you rely on other things, you will be left to these other means. So we need as Muslims not only to remember the sacrifices, but to remember what is behind these sacrifices. The belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when our brothers and sisters who are performing their Hajj, they do their salah, we remember the young woman, the young wife of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Hajar, who was looking for water for her young infant and was running between Safa and Marwa, searching for water, and she couldn't find it. And she prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help her and to help her son. And indeed she went back to her son to see the water coming under his feet. This is the miracle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Hajar and to the house of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And soon the prayers of Ibrahim, when he left his young family behind, became true. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered his prayers. فَجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِ. Let the hearts of people from always longing to visit Mecca Mukarrama, visit the Haram. And this is the answer of the prayer that today we see Hajjis from everywhere responding to the prayers of Ibrahim alayhi salam when Allah told him وَأَذَّنْ فِي النَّاسِ فِي الْحَجِّ and called people to Hajj and they shall come from every place. This is the sacrifice that we made today for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we made our dhabiha al qurban. But we need to go beyond this kind of sacrifice. Some of us, unfortunately, do not give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala half an hour of their daily time for the 5 daily prayers. Some of us are not willing to give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala some money for His sake, for zakat, for salah. So the sacrifice, when we remember Ibrahim alayhi salam, we need to carry it beyond Qurban. And as we were keen on the Mi'ad Qurban, we should be keen on other things. The salah, the 5 daily prayers, are very important elements in the life of the believers. We should never lose one of them. We should always be very attentive to the 5 daily prayers. We should be always keen to give something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the needy and the poor, not only in need, but in every day of the year. The needs of our brothers and sisters are not only on the day of Eid, but on the whole year. When we remember these sacrifices, we remember many of the sacrifices that we have made for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we do something similar or less, we always ask Allah for the rewards. So we always purify our hearts and make our niyyah purely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek the rewards from Him, and it will come to us sooner or later. Allah will reward us and we will get the best rewards for our deeds. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. We see, mashallah, people of every color, of every language, of every background, and the use of this religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said is that it belongs to every one of you. It belongs not only to Muslims, but to humanity. Any person who came on this earth and came to Islam is accepted. It belongs to it. As those who were born Muslims, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this guidelines for every human being on earth, and it will continue to be like this till the day of judgment. The unity of the Muslim Ummah, despite its diversity in language, in background is very important. And we must, as Muslims, work always towards building bridges among each other, between us, and within every Muslim in the fold of Islam. To bring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to bring the Muslim Ummah together, and to strengthen our Iman through these gatherings and similar gatherings. Finally, we feel the pain of Muslims when we come together. There are people who are making great sacrifices for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We remember our brothers in Syria who have been displaced from one place to another just because they sought the freedom. They sought to look free in their country. And they wanted this, their crime. This is their crime. And the punishment was that they were home. They were killed. They were made refugees in their homeland. And this is, we pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they ask for your prayer and your support that this calamity will soon go away and they will return to stability and they will return to happiness and peace, inshaAllah. We remember many wounds in the body of the Muslim community. Our brothers in Palestine, in Kashmir, in Somalia, in Burma, and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring peace to all of them, to bring happiness and prosperity to all of them so they could enjoy the life. But with the prayers, we need to do something more. We need to help. And our help could be most importantly with financial help. They need our support for the orphans, for the wounded, for the needy. They are in dire need of your help and support. Remember them in your prayers and remember them in your donation. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us all to the best place in our lives. Allahumma ajma'na ala ma yurdun. Wa hurbanna wa bayna ma'asin. Allahumma ajma'na ala ma ta'abina. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma ansur al-Islam wa al-Muslimin. Allahumma man arada al-Islam wa al-Muslimin khayran tawaffiqhu li kulli khayr. ومن أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين شرا فخذوا أنت عزيز وحكيم. اللهم لا تجعل في الدنيا إلا وفرحا ولا هما إلا فرجا ولا عينا إلا سترته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ظالما إلا رددته. اللهم اشف مرضانا. اللهم عاف مبتلانا. اللهم ارحم موتانا. اللهم اجعل الجنة المستقبل يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم انا نعوذ برضاك من سخطك وبمعافاتك من عقوبتك وبك مما لم نصرف ثناء عليك انت كما اثنيت على نفسك. اللهم انا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. ونعوذ بك من فتنة النار ومن فتنة المحيا والممات ومن فتنة المسيح الدجال. اللهم وإذا أردت فتنة في قوم فتوفنا غير مفتونين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان والإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا
straighten your lines and fill the gaps.
Allahu
Akbar. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله الله أكبر. الله الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله